The following solid is called a tetartoid. All its faces are irregular pentagons, an element of asymmetry. But then each face is the same irregular pentagon, making it rather symmetric. It's these elements of symmetry and asymmetry coexisting in the same solid that make it quite fascinating. Now, this isn't one solid, but a whole family of them, depending on the particular irregular pentagon making up the faces. And one particular member of the family has all its faces regular pentagons. And this is called the dodecahedron. It is a Platonic solid with 12 faces. To construct it, we start with one of the faces and duplicate that face by rotating about each of the five vertices. So this gives us six faces in total. Now rotate the five duplicated faces inwards to form a bowl and duplicate the bowl. Turn the second bowl inside out. That's six more faces for a total of 12. And connect the two bowls to form the dodecahedron. Dodeca means 12, 12 faces. Now any tetratoid can be constructed in a similar manner, but here let's start with the tetrahedron, which is another Platonic solid. First, take each edge and consider two points, a distance s from the vertices corresponding to each edge. Then take every edge and join it to the center of the tetrahedron to form this triangular plane. And then move the two yellow points, a distance t, perpendicular to the plane on either side of the edge. Let's do that with the bottom edge as well. And then simply join the three nearest red points to form a triangular face. Now join the left edge of this triangular face to the front face, the center of the front face of the tetrahedron. And connect the center of the tetrahedron to this center of the front face and extend that line until you get this plane. We have a four-sided plane so far. If you do the same thing with the bottom right vertex, we get this five-sided regular pentagon. Now, this pentagon happens to be regular, but if we change the values of S and T, we can get all kinds of other pentagons as well. Now, we could construct the other faces in a similar manner by taking those yellow and red points, but here let's make use of the rotational symmetry of the tetrahedron, meaning that rotated a certain way, the orientation of the tetrahedron is preserved. If we duplicate these pentagons as we do those rotations, we get all the faces of the tetratoid magically arranged in the form of the final solid, which is a pretty neat way to construct it, in my opinion. Now, we already saw that when t is 0, then we never move the yellow points and we stick to the tetrahedron. And for these particular values of S and T, we end up with the dodecahedron. But when S and T are same, something surprising happens. We get a cube. We can see here that it stays a cube. As S and T change, the yellow and red points move around. If you like the video, consider subscribing for more.